Previously on City of Angels.
Spread your legs. Hands on the hood.
I'm curious, Leroy, what is the learning curve with you? Is it going to take a couple of broken ribs to shut you up, or are you the baton to the forehead?
I want your name. I want your badge number. Hey!
Come here. Ah!
Tell us your name, son.
Arthur Jackson. Dr. Arthur Jackson. I'm a medical intern in this hospital, and I was robbed and shot riding my bike home.
Since dinner at your folks, you've turned down every offer to get together.
That dinner complicated things between me and my dad, Jeffrey. I need some time to sort it out.
Officer Elliot.
Do you remember me? We met this morning, traffic stop. Face in the gutter. Knee in the back.
I don't want you for my doctor.
Do you honestly think I would jeopardize my career for someone like you?
Sorry, I got stuck at checkpoint Charlie.
He's Kenneth Narbonne, motorcycle versus truck. Leg seems to be the only injury.
You call plastic surgery?
Dr. Ambrose is on his way. I didn't know you could be the medical director and a plastic surgeon.
Baffled science.
Mr. Narbonne, this is Dr. Turner, chief of surgery.
Hey, Doc. It's hurting like crazy.
Let's get a look.
How bad is it?
Give us a minute, sir. Dr. Turner, Dr. Stewart.
Riley Stewart?
Yeah, we met.
Sam Riley Stewart, I know you by reputation. You're the plastic surgeon?
Right.
What are you doing here?
I'm just working some shifts in the ER.
Why?
How come?
Long story. So I checked out your man here. He's got a soft tissue avulsion injury right down to the bone, but the foot has sensation.
You need a consult, Ben?
Yeah, thanks for coming, Mr. Narbonne. This is Dr. Ambrose.
You're about with the pavement, I understand. You sure as hell don't need a plastic surgeon. Call Ortho.
What? Who, what does he mean? Who's Ortho? What?
Excuse us a second. Let's talk in the office.
We can discuss it wherever you want, but his foot is history.
A free rectus flap can save that leg.
Perhaps you should limit your opinion to topics in emergency medicine.
Hey, he happens to be a plastic surgeon.
Be that as it may, a free flap is stupid heroics that'll just delay the inevitable. Cut that leg off, fit him with a prosthesis, and start rehab.
And why not at least look at it under anesthesia?
Ben, do you really need another disaster with a lower extremity injury? Isn't one lawsuit enough?
Can you even do a free flap? Or are your abilities limited to writing inane memos and conducting useless meetings?
It's called cleaning up the mess made by your ex-lady friend.
Doctors! Shouldn't we get back to Mr. Narbonne's leg?
You asked for a consult, I gave you a consult. You don't like it, ask somebody else. And hear this. If you're looking to make an enemy, you just succeeded.
I am shaking in my boots.
Welcome to Angels of Mercy.
Dr. Ellis did it before I got there.
He's kidding?
You guys missed some serious fireworks down here. You might want to lay low for a while. There's a rule out of Happy in bed 12.
Oh, it's mine.
Wait up for your senior resident, Courtney.
Who's second call for plastic surgery today?
Dr. Wong.
I'll put it in page 4.
Good. Tell him to meet us in the OR.
Mr. Narbonne, here's the story. Your leg is badly injured. We're going to do everything we can. But there may not be any alternative to an amputation.
Let's not think like that, please, Doc.
I drive a forklift. That's all I know how to do.
We're gonna do our best. I just can't make any promises.
There's no car for a one-legged driver. You have to fix my leg for me, Doc. You have to.
We'll do our best.
According to his office, Marvin Wong's on vacation in Hawaii.
Damn it. Well, who's next on the call list?
It doesn't matter. I can do the case myself. I've done dozens of these. I'm the best qualified.
You don't even have OR privileges.
Are you seriously going to sacrifice a kid's leg because of a credentialing issue?
This hospital did fewer than half dozen free flaps in all of last year. Can you give me some figures on success rates?
This injury, this guy?
Yeah.
Either 100% or zero. Are we going to scrub?
On those gunshots.
What's his name?
Bradley.
How's he doing?
He's not going to win a genius grant, but he's only here for a year. Don't want to say hello?
Sorry, I didn't call you last night. The grapevine was clogged and I didn't get in until midnight.
Forget it. So how was San Fran? Were your pals?
Good,
that's it?
I have some news, but promise me you're gonna keep calm. I got offered the trauma nurse coordinator job at Oakland Memorial.
You didn't tell me this trip was for a job interview.
Well, before Dr. Price left, she said if I was ever up north to give her a call. So I did, and we had lunch, and she offered me the job.
And you're actually considering it?
Well, it's a great position, and it pays well, and Oakland Memorial hasn't had two rapes in the last 6 weeks. There's no half-hour line at the front door to get your ID checked, or a buddy system just to walk down the hall or go pee.
No, that's all loosening up.
Jenny Cole was raped in a restricted area where security was supposedly tight, so don't tell me about loosening up.
I'm just trying to understand why all this is reason to leave Los Angeles.
Can we talk about this later, Jeffrey?
It's 400 miles away.
It's an hour flight.
With my busy schedule, might as well be Taiwan. So, congratulations and I'll never see you again?
How about just congratulations?
Grace, I love you. I want to marry you. How can you do this to me?
This isn't about you or what you want. This is about something good that happened to me.
The gunshots are here.
Gunslingers looking to kill each other out of the port off Wilshire.
Hey, man, I didn't do nothing.
Save it. On my count. One, two, three. Jackson, you take this one.
Gunshot to the mid-abdomen. Pressure's about 80.
He's gonna need some O-negatives.
Ready? On my count. One, two, three. Let's get him on the monitor.
What's his name? Hall. Donato Hall.
I know him. I know his whole family. Donato. Arthur Jackson here.
70 over panel.
Hang on, Donato.
We need to get him to OR now.
I don't want to die, man. Please don't let me die. You're going to be okay, Donato. Just hang on.
Arthur, you have another patient to take care of. Let's move in.
You got one coming up, stat.
Clear the way, please.
Anterior tibial artery's gone, but we can plug into peroneal right here.
I can't seem to find the micro instruments.
How's he supposed to work without them?
No, it's all right. We'll make do. Okay, here's the avulsed end of the tibial nerve.
You going to put in a sural graft?
Why, Dr. Williams, you got someplace better to be? Proline suture.
Just wondering.
Now stick around and watch. Splash, please. So, talk to me about the operating microscope, good nurse Joanne.
We've got the scope, but we're having some trouble with the light source.
Well, I'll muddle through without it. But you're not going to see anything elegant today.
We've learned to do all this without special instruments.
Congo. Afghanistan, Mozambique.
Doctors International?
That's right. Pretty much learn how to operate with a knife and a fork.
Very impressive.
You gonna be able to do the rectus flap?
You think I'd still be screwing around here if I couldn't do the flap? I'd be having lunch.
We're bringing an abdominal GSW into room 2.
Dr. Liu's on call today.
He's doing an appy with Dr. Ellis.
Well, you can go ahead and take off. Don't worry. Free flap's gonna work like a charm.
Need me, I'll be in the next room.
I'll be right here. Happy to be operating on this beautiful day.
a lot of damage for a single bullet.
Leave him pretty much under control if he could just hold a blood pressure without cardiac massage.
I'm not sure what else to do, Ben. Crit's 30 and the presses are wide open.
Bradley, poke in the damn liver. Sponge.
There's enough bleeding without our making more. Here. Come off, Jeffrey. Let's see what we've got.
Flatline, Ben. No electrical activity.
They want it cross-clamped. What do you got?
Still nothing.
That's it. Mark the time. We're gonna need some big sutures on an autopsy needle. Let's close them up.
Sorry, Arthur.
You know him?
Yeah, I grew up a block away from his family. I used to hang with his older brother.
Bullet blew the celiac trunk right off the aorta. Not much we could do. Is the family downstairs?
I'll find them. I'd like to talk to his mom, if you don't mind.
No, I'd appreciate that. Just a second. When you are retracting, hold these. You need to place steady pressure. And don't fidget so much.
I didn't realize that the edge of this retractor was so sharp.
A good workman never blames his tools, Damon.
This is all. I don't know if you remember me. I'm Arthur Jackson.
Flora Jackson's boy. I heard you'd become a doctor.
You must be Marcus, right? I remember you were a science champ. I used to hang with Darnell.
Is Donato dead or what?
Were you taking care of Donato, Arthur?
I saw him when he came in, and I've just left his surgery. Mrs. Hall, I think we need a minute alone.
Is he gone?
We did everything we could.
Oh, no.
Can't we go now?
You be still, Marcus.
I got some place to be.
Marcus, don't you think you should be with your mama right now?
Get your damn hands off of me.
He's just upset, Mrs. Hall.
I wish that's all it was.
Is there anybody you can be with? I'll call Darnell if you'd like.
Arthur, Darnell's dead.
I didn't know.
He got into the gangs before his brother. He brought Donato in with him. Now they're both dead.
I'm so sorry.
You know, gangs took that boy's daddy in a grocery holdup.
I did know that.
Now he's got two brothers dead. I won't survive losing him, too.
If there's anything I can do.
I was so proud to hear of your accomplishments. Everybody is real proud.
I'm not incompetent, and I'm not stupid. I just got a little cramp in my arm and made me jerk the tractor.
I wasn't there, but if Turner chewed your ass, it needed chewing.
Did he say something to you about it?
No, man, it's just he chewed on me for 2 years, so I know what I'm talking about.
I know I sound paranoid, but it's tough not knowing if you have a job next year.
Yeah, I can imagine. What happened at the place you did your internship?
Lousy environment. Rednecks never gave me a chance to make the cut.
Where'd you intern with Rednecks?
Clarkstown Memorial, Helena, Montana.
Really? You know Sid Ashton? He was at Clarkstown Memorial. We went to med school together.
Yeah, sure. He was my best pal. Wesley, what do I have to do to keep my job around here?
Dr. Turner's never admitted someone to the residency from a one-year position. But if it's ever going to happen, you need to read, be on time, and not make excuses. If you screw up, you own it, learn from it, and move on.
Well, if that's the way you want it, then that's the way it's going to be.
It's not a matter of what I want, Damon. It's a matter of what's right.
Yeah, sure. Hey, do me a favor. If you see Dr. Turner, tell him I said I felt bad about what happened in surgery, okay?
He's probably forgotten about it by now, Damon.
Yeah, probably so.
Sorry I'm late.
It's inauspicious, Ben, when the defendant shows up late to his own deposition. You're inauspicious.
Let's get started.
Officer Elliott's attorneys have scheduled Annette Peeler's deposition for day after tomorrow, so it's imperative we're all on the same page.
Dr. Turner performed the perfect surgery with the perfect outcome.
Since Officer Elliott's permanently disabled, I suspect they're not totally in agreement with your assessment. Doctor, why don't you take a seat?
Leg was perfect when he left Angels of Mercy. And if Elliott had stayed under my care, he wouldn't be hobbling around filing bogus lawsuits.
No, he'd be back on the street arresting innocent black folk.
Were there any complications during surgery?
None.
What was his prognosis for recovery?
Excellent. Until he went to his private hack, whose totally unadvised reoperation screwed up a textbook on anastomosis.
Folks, if the hostility gets through to those depositions or trial, you'll sink a case we could probably settle out for 50 grand.
50 grand? Is that a possibility, Alexander?
Oh, hell no. You don't settle.
50 grand versus 10 or 100 times, that sounds like a bargain to me, Ben.
You don't settle this case for 50 grand or 50 cents. My work was exemplary, more than he deserved.
More of that hostility.
If I'd done wrong to that cop, I'd take my lumps. I did good work.
Then let's put the spotlight on that instead of the angry man routine.
Look here, counselor. If this case settles, it's a permanent blemish on my career. So you take that option off the table.
Amen, doctor.
Ms. Peeler, Courtney Ellis. I'm a surgical intern.
Oh, I heard you were with us. You're Langston Ellis' daughter.
Every day.
I guess it's not easy having a famous father.
Yeah, well, he's in Seattle and I'm in L.A., so...
Say no more.
It's nice meeting you, and don't expect much privacy. That latch is broken.
What else is new?
I just got a call from Bernard McLaren, chief of surgery at Brooklyn General. Something you want to tell me?
I'm looking into a position up there.
Yeah, well, he mentioned that. Jeffrey, come here. Did you consider talking to me about this?
I was going to when things were more final.
According to Dr. McLaren, all that's left is the paperwork. Courtney, can you give us a minute?
I should have talked to you first.
You're aware this job is a preliminary third year with no guarantee of a fourth? You want to be in the same position as Bradley?
If I work hard enough, I'll get the fourth year.
It's a dead end, Jeffrey. 6 months, you were looking for a new job, McLaren guaranteed.
He hasn't seen my work yet.
Annette Peeler tells me Grace Patterson's leaving. I assume there's a connection. Yeah. If you need time to help us settle, I can juggle the vacation schedule. But just up and leaving, Jeffrey, you're throwing away your career.
No, I can't look at that in the face of losing this relationship.
If you don't follow her, where is it guaranteed you're going to break up?
You tell me, Dr. Turner. How are you and Dr. Price doing? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I was way out of line.
It's true we are no longer together, but that has nothing to do with her going back up north. Now, I will wait to look for a replacement until you have a resignation on my desk in writing. But you think long and hard on this, Jeffrey. Once you're gone, you're gone. Oh, God. Lynette.
What the hell happened?
Get the police.
Let's get some help over here. Step up onto the bed, Lynette.
Just get the police.
Weiss, give me 309 on a small cutting needle. Grab security. Some betadine, quickly, please.
Security are set.
My immediate instinct was to hold the door shut. But it was almost as if he knew about the latch. He pushed it open.
Did you get any kind of a look at his face?
He pulled me to my feet and spun me around so quickly, no.
Did you see the weapon?
I'll finish suturing later.
No, please finish it now. I want to get done here as soon as we can.
Okay.
The weapon. I only felt it against my neck. It was a large knife, like a switchblade. I heard him opening it.
So he was behind you at this point?
Yes. He entered me from behind, and when he was finished, he pushed me forward. I fell across the toilet. I heard the door open and close. He was gone.
Thank you, Miss Peeler. I think this is enough for now. We're sorry about what happened.
Thank you, detectives.
We'll be in touch.
Grace, can you fetch me my scrubs?
Sure. Tough lady.
Third rape in 6 weeks. When are you guys gonna catch this son of a bitch?
We're on our commander to give us some undercover. Maybe get some funds for surveillance cameras. There are thousands of employees in this hospital.
Yeah, and tens of thousands of visitors and patients.
And we're not catching any breaks. This guy knows what he's doing.
Dr. Turner. Gwen Pennington.
A psychiatrist. We met before.
I just heard about Lynette. Was she seen by the rape counseling team?
Yeah, they did a good job.
I'm sure she has all the doctors she needs right now. Please tell her I asked after her. And if you don't mind giving her my card with my home number, she can call, night or day.
I'm sure she'll appreciate it.
Thank you.
Dr. Gwen Pennington wanted you to have her number.
She's a nice lady, very sensible in committee meetings.
So, if you're ready, I'll have somebody drive you home.
I'm not going home, I'm going back to work.
That would work, Lynette.
Have a full afternoon.
This is not business as usual. You need some rest. Take some time.
Because that's what we tell our rape victims to do, isn't it? I may have been raped, but I am not a rape victim.
You're the boss, Lynette.
Hey, Dr. Turner. I saw Mr. Narbonne in recovery. Flap looks great.
Thanks.
What's all the excitement about?
Where have you been? Lynette Peeler was raped in a staff restroom on 9.
Jeez. Are you kidding? That's awful.
I think she got the laceration when she fell.
I've been paging you for over an hour. What's the story?
Battery went dead.
Some people carry an extra. I hate to break this up, doctor, but we've got a lot of patients. Bad news, Dr. Turner. Half the night's just calling in sick, and the rest are probably out looking for jobs.
See if some of the on-duty staff will fill in for the night, and I'll inform Ron Harris.
Gentlemen, we've double security detail on every shift, and we're going to an after-dark lockdown procedure. Dr. Ambrose, please.
Thanks, Ron.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I've just been down to the ER, and I wanted to let you all know that we've got a significant problem brewing.
Thanks. Whatever it is, we'll handle it in due time.
Are you aware that you have female staff running for the exits?
We're planning an open forum to discuss all safety concerns first thing in the morning.
And we're looking at having to shut down the ER tonight.
We're aware of the problem, Doctor, and we're going to deal with it.
How could you be aware when I was just told 2 minutes ago?
It's awfully presumptuous to think you're the only one who knows what's going on in this hospital. Now, if you'll excuse us.
Okay, we're going to have to shut down trauma. And in case nobody told you, Doctor, we are a trauma center.
You have had a bug up your butt since I got here, and I've tolerated it. But now it's getting in the way of my doing my job. And that I will not tolerate.
I'll be out of your hair the minute I hear something that'll get our ER nurses to stay the night.
Just tell them if they spend more time following security protocols and less time deciding what cute little skirt to wear, maybe this stuff won't keep happening.
So you're saying that the victims brought it on themselves?
Oh, come on, Ben. He wasn't saying that. It's just been like pulling teeth, getting people to take simple precautions.
He said what he said. I'd call you a heartless bureaucrat.
Ben!
Ron! I'm sorry. This guy can kiss my ass.
Just give me a minute.
Ben! Ben! Ben!
In here. What the hell's gotten into you, Ben?
That pompous idiot is mismanaging the worst internal crisis this hospital has ever
seen. This management team is doing everything that could be done.
And you're lucky there were no females at your little administrative stag party, or you'd be dealing with a riot right now.
But I guess that was by design.
Oh, if you're dredging up Lillian Price, it was her choice to conduct a personal relationship with the chief of surgery while serving as the medical director. No one else.
It was your choice to force her to leave.
Every physician in this hospital has the right to a level playing field and an impartial medical director. She was not forced to leave, only to relinquish her administrative position, or you, Ben, to relinquish yours.
Now, you sure got a terrific replacement.
Dr. Ambrose is the medical director, and you owe him your respect.
No, no. You get the respect you earn. Ambrose is a mediocrity by any measure, and I owe him nothing.
Ben, Nate Ambrose is going to be around here a good long time. My view of things, you can work with him, or you can work someplace else.
Sign into this area. 10-4,
we're going to be around.
Dr.
Wong. Dr.
Turner. I thought you were in Hawaii.
Oh, I wish. I've been in clinics since sunup.
You never got a call on a mangled extremity?
No, I miss anything good.
Marvin, you ever hear of a plastic surgeon named Raleigh Stewart?
That's like asking a pitcher if he knows who Sandy Koufax is. This is a guy who turned down an endowed chair at Columbia 1 year out of training.
Yeah, why would a guy like that want to pull ER shifts here?
Who knows? Last I heard, he was working in Sierra Leone, but he had to come back because of a health problem of some sort.
Huh. All right, thanks for the info.
Have him call me, please. I have a couple cases I could use his opinion on.
You bet. Stuart, I just ran into Marvin Wong.
Well, I hope he brought you some macadamia nuts.
I don't need another smartass.
Look, taking his place was the quickest and the best way to accomplish the task at hand. And Mr. Narbonne's gonna appreciate the result, as should you.
Regardless, I don't appreciate being lied to.
Wait, you can't tell me that you never cut a corner to help a patient?
To a degree, but what you pulled may play in Sierra Leone. But here, it'll get you kicked off of medical staff.
Anything but that.
Well, hey, man, if that's your attitude, why aren't you still in Africa?
I got sick. Found a lymph node in my neck. Turned out to be stage 3 Hodgkin's.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Well, radiation and chemo seem to have done the trick.
Why didn't you go back?
You know, I wasn't sure that I wanted to. The last thing that I did before I left was to close stumps on 17 preschoolers. And they'd each had an arm hacked off. And I thought that this would be a good way to measure the depth of my commitment.
While you're measuring your commitment, maybe you wouldn't mind joining the plastic surgery panel. Put in me for commitment there.
Wait, I'm going to save you the headache. You know, I've got a short fuse. I detest bureaucracy. I don't take orders. And I cannot abide stupidity. It's like my ex-wife used to say, I'm not quite housebroken.
This isn't a marriage proposal. I just need good surgeons. It doesn't work out, we go our separate ways.
I don't dabble. I either do something or I don't.
Think about it. And check out the neighborhood while you're at it. Without the care we provide, our patients wouldn't have any care at all. If you're a guy looking to save the world, not a bad place to start. Keeps me coming back each morning.
Dr. Jackson, walk-in's got a Mrs. Hall asking for you.
I'm on my way. Mrs. Hall?
I am so sorry to bother you, Arthur, but I'm gonna lose all my boys. They're all gonna be dead.
Did something happen to Marcus, Mrs. Hall?
He was riding in a car with some gang boys, and they got stopped for running a red light, and one of them had a gun.
You think they were trying to pay back whoever shot Donato?
Marcus knows who did it, but he won't tell me, and he won't say a word to the police. He is so smart. And he was doing so well in school. And now I'm going to lose my last boy, Arthur.
Where is he now?
Rampart Division. He's waiting to be picked up. But if I get him alone, he's going to be back on the street in 5 minutes.
Would you like me to talk to him, Mrs. Hall?
I don't know who else to turn to.
Let me see if I can take off a little early. And then we'll head down there. Come on.
You took your time?
Don't get up, Marcus. We've got to talk.
What's this we? What's he doing here?
Your mama wanted me to talk some sense into you.
We got nothing to talk about.
What were you doing in the car?
Just riding.
Just riding? Three gangbangers in a 38? Sounds to me like you were looking to do a murder.
Hey, we was just riding.
Your mama says you've been hanging with dudes wearing colors and flashing gang signs. She also says you've been cutting school and got busted holding dope.
Wasn't mine.
Let me ask you something. If Donato came back for 1 minute to tell you one thing, do you think he'd tell you to get the guy who shot him, maybe get yourself killed, or to get your ass off the street and make something of yourself?
Ain't no question there, man.
Your brother is lying dead on a slab. You think he'd want the same for you?
I ain't going down like him.
This brown stuff bulletproof? Looks like plain old skin to me.
Man, let go. Man, let go, man.
You keep this up, you're dead. That's what your brothers would tell you.
Nah, they be talking about loyalty to the set. And seeing to it, they're not only forgotten.
So you're gonna do that by getting yourself killed or going to jail?
They do it for me.
Mrs. Hall,
why don't you head on home?
I'm gonna take Marcus for a ride. Show him something.
Hey, forget that. All right, man, what are we gonna see?
Nothing you can't handle, big man.
As a friend. All right, all right. Don't worry about it.
What's up?
Everyone who said they'd fill in for the night shift is leaving.
What about replacements?
Nursing's checking the registry, and I'm trying to call in friends, but it's a bust. Unless the people who are here right now stay for the night, we're gonna have to shut down the ER.
Somebody call for an escort?
Oh, 2 seconds, Dwayne.
Wait, Dwayne, hang tight a minute. Bernice, if you leave, other nursing units will follow. We're gonna have to shut down the hospital.
Dr. Turner, my shift is over. I'm going home.
I know you're scared. We're all scared.
Except you're a big, beautiful man, Dr. Turner. And this psycho isn't after big, beautiful men. Excuse me.
Medical alert wants to transfer a construction worker, fell off a scaffold, head injury with altered mental status. Are we open or what?
The whole system is swamped today. If he doesn't come here, he'll go to a non-trauma hospital.
You want to let that happen?
I want to get home to my family.
They need an answer.
Yeah.
Except the patient.
Annette, what are you doing here?
Rumor has it we're short-handed on the night shift, so I'm working.
No, honey, you gotta go home.
Until we're staffed up, I'll be here working. Go home if you need to, but I can't be thinking about myself when this patient's coming in. What's the ETA?
I haven't told him to come yet.
Do it.
Whoa.
Look, we will work the shift, but only if you go home soon.
Go.
Send the patient for trauma.
May I interrupt? Of course. Ben, you know Gwen Penny. Nice to see you again.
How's Lynette doing?
She just single-handedly kept the trauma center open. In other words, she's still here.
It's not unusual with rape survivors. Working a normal schedule to regain a sense of control.
I was wondering if you wouldn't mind stopping in to talk with them. You know, just check her temperature a little.
I was looking for an excuse to do just that.
Oh, thanks.
No problem.
So, what's her story?
Do you mean is she single?
No. No, you trying to set me up?
I think you need a little distraction.
I find my distractions.
Well, they must be in the hospital because your car's always in the parking lot.
Not always.
She attended the University of London. She trained at Cornell, and yes, she does happen to be single. She's also cheerful, smart, and very good at her job. You ought to check it out.
Not yet, Ethan.
Do yourself a favor, Doctor. Make it soon.
Hey, Lynette. How you doing?
I'm hanging in there. Thanks for your phone numbers.
You want to go get some coffee? Maybe talk a little?
I don't think so, not right now.
Oh, no shrink stuff. Just talk. It's good medicine.
I don't feel much like medicine right now, thanks.
Well, maybe not at this moment, but take it from me, you are going to hit a wall. If not today, then tomorrow, next week, next month. Everybody does. I did.
You were attacked?
I was physically and sexually assaulted when I was 15. The help I got at the time was noteworthy, mainly for its absence.
15's a child. Must have been horrible.
No more horrible than for you.
It wasn't horrible for me, just a stupid crime, nothing more.
A purse snatching is a stupid crime. You were violated by a lousy, rotten bastard. You will get through this, but you can't go it alone.
I have to run over to 4 West, deliver a 20-year pin to one of the LVNs.
You know where to find me. Anytime.
Thanks.
That's my brother. What are they doing to him?
He's being autopsied. Why are you walking away? Cold-hearted killer like you ought to be able to see his own brother saw it open and not give a damn.
Yeah, I'm thinking about who shot him and when this is gonna happen to him.
You ought to be worrying about your responsibilities.
And that is my responsibility.
That's for the cops, son. You're the man of your family now. How about taking care of your mama? See, that's how I define being a man.
You ain't on the street.
22 slug, still in there. The guy that did it, I had my chance for revenge. But for all kinds of reasons, I didn't take it. I like to think I was a man in making that choice. Look at him, meeting a butcher shop.
Yo, you enjoying this? You getting off on this?
This makes me sick, Marcus. Because when I look in there, I don't see the noddle cut open and splayed out. It's you.
That ain't gonna happen.
Boy, it is gonna happen. And you're gonna leave your mother all alone and heartbroken. And it won't be on account of you being a man, but being a fool. Look at Donato. You think he wants to be forgotten as a dead gangbanger? Or remembered as a young man taken away too soon, but taught you what being a man was really about? It's up to you, Marcus. What's more important? Taking care of your mama, carrying on your family name, or your fool's revenge?
What are they doing now?
They're making a scalp incision. It's gonna peel off his skin and cut open his head.
Could you stop him? I want to go home.
Doctor. Yeah, I was just coming to find you. Did you see Lynette? What do you think?
I think she's going home and she knows we're here if she needs us.
Oh, great. Well, I thank you for spending the time.
I hope it helped.
Yeah, Gwen, doctor? I was wondering if you might have some time for me.
You mean counseling?
Actually, I meant more in the way of dinner. If you're hungry. Or what's the British term? Peckish, if you're feeling at all peckish.
I might be feeling a bit peckish.
Would you like to grab a bite?
All right, doctor. In 10 minutes at the lift?
10 minutes at the lift.
Patricia, call 912. How are you doing, Mr. Peeler? I'm Damon Bradley. I'm a second-year surgeon resident.
Yes, I saw you in the ER today.
I couldn't help but overhear about what happened to you today. I think you're a very brave person.
Thanks.
I know they have security and escorts, but if you'd like, I could walk into your car.
That's very kind of you, but it's not necessary.
I know it's none of my business, but if you ever need someone to talk to about what happened, I'm a very good listener.
Thanks, but I'll be all right.
This may be a wild guess, but I take it you're not from around these here parts.
Boy gave me away. I was born in London, Belgravia. Mother's a forensic pathologist, father's American. He was a journalist with the LA Times before he died. They met in England when I was about 2. We moved back here for his work. They divorced when I was about 15. I moved back to England with my mom, and then I came back to do my residency.
Brothers and sisters?
2 brothers, both older.
Either of them doctors?
Oh, Terence is a lawyer, and my elder brother, Curtis, he has some mental difficulties. He doesn't do much of anything at the moment. What about you? I hear you had a busted on-campus love affair.
You've been doing research on me?
Casually. I understand you were engaged.
Yeah, well, in the distant past. When we got back together when she came to Angels of Mercy. And about 6 months ago, I got involved in a frivolous lawsuit that's still ongoing, and my leadership of the surgical department came into question. And at the same time, it was suggested that Lillian might not be able to do her job properly given our relationship. So she was invited to resign.
So she left?
6 months ago to run a consortium of hospitals up in Northern California.
You didn't follow.
No, I broke up a few months after.
Do you miss her?
Don't I miss her? I miss her company. And yeah, I guess I'll always love her in a way, but we were never right together. So.
Refill?
You still